For most women, bad hair days can cause a lot of stress and a lot of frustration. But imagine your hair falling out in clumps at unpredictable times.
Yeah, it can be really frustrating. Hair loss is truly devastating for women. And that's what one Frederick woman has been dealing with her whole life. Tonight, she puts vanity aside to tell her story.
36-year-old Jennifer Thomas has beautiful, thick hair. But right now, it's falling out in clumps.
As long as I can remember, I've had this condition.
It's called alopecia areata, an autoimmune disease that causes her immune system to attack her hair follicles.
It's pretty bizarre. You don't know when it's going to show up. You don't know how far it's going to progress.
There is no cure, and steroid treatments are uncomfortable.
They do injections into the scalp and the area that's affected.
Before this latest episode, Jen hadn't lost hair for 5 years.
So after 5 years, how did you first notice that something was starting to go on again?
You know, you brush your hair, pull your fingers through your hair.
Right.
And I was pulling, and there was just hair coming out, and a lot of hair.
Wow. That must have been disheartening, is putting it mildly, I'm sure.
Yes. I was in tears. I was distraught. I was like, why does this have to happen to me again?
Jen showed us where she's missing patches around her ears and a larger bald spot in the back.
When you do your hair in the morning, you do what?
This mirror is perfect because I can see the back of my head and I can make sure that it's covered.
After she started losing hair again, Jen went online and saw that MD Anderson Cancer Center in Houston was conducting a study.
We're doing gene hunting, basically.
The study is headed by Dr. Madeline Duvick. The goal, register as many alopecia areata sufferers as possible.
And by identifying the genes that cause the disease, we'll be able to come up with better treatments and possibly cures in the future.
5,800 patients are involved in the study so far. Half of them have given blood and skin samples, including Jen. And that's why Jen wanted to talk to us. She hopes that other sufferers will also register for this study.
It may not result in a cure for me, but it might help somebody else down the road.
Yeah, and to show you just how well Jen has been able to hide her hair loss, so far she's been lucky that it's in places that
right.
She can. But she's a friend of one of our producers who was completely unaware that she had this problem until she came forward and said, I think this would be a really interesting story for you guys.
Yeah, it's very nice for her to come forward and try to help others. Well,